some of your past mistakes. You are more than the problems you create. You've been remade. You are more than the choices that you've made. You are more than the sum of your past mistakes. You are more than the problems you create. You've been remade. 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 Welcome back to another week of Life Palette. I'm so glad that you've been a part of this journey. And today we're going to wrap this up. It's the finish of the series Life Palette. But I want to encourage you to continue on in relationships and a small group and life group environment. Today we want to talk about the finishing touches of a masterpiece. You know, somebody told me just this last week, they said, you know, if God had a cell phone, he'd have your picture on it. And I thought, that's great. I'm a grandfather. I have my grandson's picture on there. I have my kids' pictures on there. Why? Because I'm just so proud of them. They're a masterpiece in my lineage somehow. I don't know how all that works as a human, but God would say, you're his masterpiece. He's so proud of you. I am so proud of my kids, my grandson. You need to know this. If you haven't gotten this throughout this series, you are not an accident. You didn't just randomly happen. God pre-planned you. You are a well-thought-out masterpiece. And he is so proud of you. And we need to accept that and begin living in that and begin reveling in his love that way. And one of the ways we know that's true are the finishing touches. As an artist, when I paint a painting, I love being able to see it finished all the way through, even to the point of being framed. That's so important. I don't put my signature on it until it's done and I'm happy with it. You know, I want to frame it. And God has some finishing touches for our lives as his masterpiece that we need to experience, that we need to see, that we need to live out every day. I wrote in the book about how God, one of the finishing touches is he's passionately pursuing us. And, you know, I'm passionate as an artist. When I get a composition in mind and I want to finish it, I'm passionate about seeing it through to the end. Well, God's passionately pursuing you. And in the book, I wrote the story about how I got lost on a mountain hike and some friends came and found me. And God is passionately pursuing you every day. You need to start seeing that. You need to start expecting that. Looking for where he's pursuing you because he is very passionate about you. The second thing that's a finishing touch, not only is he passionately pursuing you, but he has signed you. His signature is on your life as his masterpiece. You know, if you have a painting without a signature, it's just a painting. It's not a masterpiece. I would hate to find a painting that I thought was some famous artist in the past, but they didn't sign it. The signature is so important. It adds so much value and worth. That's what makes it a masterpiece, is who the artist is. Otherwise, it's just a painting. Well, your life has been signed as God's masterpiece. Isaiah chapter 49 says that he has written his name on our lives in the palm of his hands. And as a follower of Christ, I hope you understand that is a picture of Jesus Christ going to the cross for us and taking literally the nails through his hands, his feet, as a signature of his love for us as his masterpiece, as his passionate pursuit. The third finishing touch that God has made very evident in our lives that shows that we're his masterpiece is his love. I talk about in the book about love squared. It's about framing, and I have a frame here. This is actually a custom frame that I'll be painting to. I have three of them just like this. And instead of starting the painting, I'm starting with the frame, and I am painting a painting to the frame. Well, in the same way, God has created our lives toward the frame of his love. The width of his love. His love is so wide. You will never go wider in life than his love. The length of his love. You can never go further than his love. Well, his love will all extend to wherever you are. He's framed our lives in the height and the depth of his love. His love is the right frame for our lives as a masterpiece. Anything else will make our lives look like a cheap forgery. So we need to live out His love every day as His masterpiece. God sees us through the lens of the masterpiece He created before we even feel like we get there or arrive there. In fact, the Bible tells us, we see in Scripture, Paul writes that we will not be fully like Jesus Christ until we see Him face to face. We're growing and becoming like the masterpiece He created us to be more and more every day. But He sees us as the finished product already, the finished masterpiece. I look at Peter in the New Testament and I think about how Jesus, here's Peter. He's the one who denied Jesus. He's the one that wouldn't stand up for Jesus. And yet Jesus Himself said, Peter, here's who I am going to call you. I see you as the rock. He went from Simon to Peter, the rock, the solid one. And yet that was anything but his character at that point. But Jesus saw the end product. He saw him as a masterpiece. He saw him as the one who was going to do the first message of the New Testament. My question for all of us as we come to the end of this series, Life Palette, is can people see God's signature in your life? Can people see that we are His masterpiece? Are we living that life? Because He wants us to. He created us to reflect His glory. He created us in such a way that people would see Him through our lives as His masterpiece. Now, I want to encourage you. I want to pray that we would be able to do that every day in our lives. And we would just more and more every day reflect Him as His masterpiece. But I want to encourage you to do a couple things. First of all, continue to develop your life palette. Get better at this every day. Prayerfully ask God to help you go forward in this. Join with a partner, with a friend, somebody that will hold you accountable. And I would encourage you to make that your life group. I hope you've enjoyed the experience of doing life together with some other folks, and that they're encouraging you along the way, and that you're encouraging them. And I want to just challenge you, continue in these relationships. Walk this out together, because God's created you as His masterpiece. Let's pray. Father, we are so grateful as we look at our lives. There are so many things that I personally can look at my life and think, there is no way God declares me as His masterpiece. But Lord, You've created us as Your masterpiece. And there are things in our lives, Lord, that we want to get off of our life palette, that it's hindering us living that life. And there are things that we need to add on in our values, our creativity, our consistency, our relationships. Lord, there are things that we need to add on, and they need to become habits in our life every day so that we can reflect Your love, that our lives would reflect the masterpiece of Your love every day. Thank You, Lord, that You are passionately pursuing us. Lord, even as I'm praying and as we're talking and as the groups are going to discuss here in a few moments, there are some folks who have never really felt Your passionate pursuit. Let them have that sense during this discussion that You are passionately pursuing them, even to the point of the cross. Lord, that You have signed us, You signed our lives with the blood of Jesus Christ. We're worth the cross of Christ. That's even for us hard to say sometimes, Lord. But help us to see that You have signed us as Your masterpiece. It's written on the palm of Your hands. And Lord, thank You that You framed our lives with Your incredible love. We talk about amazing grace and Your mercies, and it is so amazing. Lord, when we see that Your love frames our lives, You go behind us, or You're behind us, You're before us, everywhere You are there, Lord, with Your love. Lord, there are some areas of our lives right now that as we're talking in the next few minutes, that maybe we've never seen the frame of Your love. Would You help us to do that? And I pray, God, that as we go forward, we would grow closer to You, we would grow closer to one another, and that we would live life as the masterpiece You created us to be. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.